So we're going to talk about transformation and obviously agile transformation. And what I want to focus on is really what does it take to transform big companies? The data shows that it seems to be particularly difficult to transform companies. There have been some recent data showing that more than 90% of agile transformation fail. Well, it depends, of course, of what we call fail, but at least fail to deliver real capability to adapt to changing environments. And many companies do report that they have improved their delivery, but they still struggle with the final outcome. So before we start, indeed, there are a couple of questions. Okay, so yeah, Skyfall. You know, I'm French, and the Gauls, the ancestors of the French people, they were supposed to be very good warriors and very brave warriors. But what they fear most is for the sky to fall on their head, right? So that was the big big fear, and this is what we're going to talk about today. Is what are the conditions and the reasons of problems? Okay, fasten seatbelt then. So my name is Yann. My background is in software engineering. I've been doing a lot of software and project and so on. And I used to use Agile and Extreme Programming back in the 90s. So I'm a bit of a gray hair guy, and started with Agile quite a while ago and then moved into consulting and helping companies to adopt Agile on a large scale, right? On a big organization for application and systems that were usually pretty critical. So either business critical, safety critical, air traffic control systems, and these kind of things. So mainly, using Agile in a constrained environment, I would say. And I created with my partner a company called Y Innovation back in 2014 that is really specialized in Agile transformation and in Agile transformation for mainly large companies. And here I want to say a couple of things about what I call agile transformation. I'm not talking about Scrum or Kanban here, right? We are talking really about agile enterprise. We are talking about adaptive organization. We are talking about setting up capabilities, setting up companies that can very fastly listen to their market, innovate, and develop fast solutions, service products, whether they are digital or not. Right, to go to market very quickly and create this adaptive environment, you know, adaptive company, able to really react fast to the changes and come back with new ideas quickly. Right, so we want to talk about framework, we are talking about design thinking, we are talking about lean startup, we are talking about business modeling, business canvas, innovation. We are talking about product management, road mapping. We are talking about developing products. So using whether Scrum, Kanban, less safe, whatever framework, and also DevOps for delivering and so on. But we're also talking about leadership. We are talking about organizational transformation, organizational design. We are talking about changing HR. We are talking about changing supplier management way of working. We are talking about finance, budgeting. So it's really a very wide transformation of the way of working, but also of the mindset and culture DNA of the companies. So in terms of clients, so as you can see here, we work a lot with organizations that are quite large, right? That are very often global organization across region, across different countries, with different cultures, with different business lines and so on, right? So whether these are some of the customers that we have in mainland China, but we are also offices in Singapore and Hong Kong. And as you can see, same kind of clients, right? Finance represent about 40 or 50% of our clients. Today, I'm going to talk about Singapore Airline. We have done the transformation of Cathay Pacific. We have done it at the Singapore Airline, and I'll take this example because I really found that SIA is a great example of well-performing, pretty effective transformation of Agile in a pretty quick time frame, which is not so often. So the first thing I'd like to talk about this afternoon is First and foremost, I'd like to discuss about what it takes to transform big companies. So I'm not talking about startup, or I'd like to talk really about the problems that are linked to being big. And then I will present a little bit the overall transformation of Singapore Airlines. So why is it so difficult to transform large organization? There are a few impediments that are linked to the nature of being large, right? So because it's big companies, it's a big problem to solve. Usually large, big companies have been operating for very long. So some of our clients, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, some 100 years running business, right? So of course, a lot of legacy, technical debt of the IT system, but also legacy organization, legacy processes, legacy culture, and so on and so on and so forth, right? Very top down. You in big companies, you have a lot of power, you have politics. Well, there are a lot of things that makes it difficult. Now, this being said, they have also, I would say, strength, right? I call them unfair advantage. They are big, they have a lot of money, they have resources, they have a long history, they have a lot of data. They have a lot of things that they can use as well to build their transformation more successfully compared to others. So yeah, some of the key ingredients. So one thing about transformation is that there is no recipe. There is no one formula. Each company will have to do its own process, its own way of transforming, right? But for sure, there are a few key points that they need, that we need to have if we want to be successful. So you have mentioned the leadership support. Let's be clear, leadership support does not mean that we want the big boss to say, guys, you go for the transformation. Leadership support means that we want the leaders to get involved in the transformation, to be part of it, all right? To be on the ground floor, to be really talking to the team, getting closer to the teams and understand really the transformation problems that people are facing. So very often we have very good support from top management. They really want it, but they don't get involved, right? So they just supervise, and that's not good enough. So some of the things that I will also mention is a structured, very structured way of doing the transformation. Transformation is a change management process. It's a very complex process, and it has to be very structured. It requires a lot of new skills, right? And therefore, they need to be a joint effort with HR to really work on skills update. I'll come back on the be agile versus do agile. I have a bit of my opinion on this, but I'll come back on that. There was also some point mentioned before about not enough effort or things like this, and I will talk as well about the dimensioning of the transformation. When we talk about the leadership, there is one thing that you need to do when you do a transformation is to educate leaders. So we need to have leaders to be humble enough to understand that they need to also better understand and accept to be trained. You know, I like the picture of the stairs. You know, when you groom the stairs, you need to start from the top, right? So in the transformation, it's the same. You need to educate and you need to push. You need to have leadership pushing top down, but you want to build the transformation bottom up. That we need leadership top down. We need a very strong push from the leaders about their willingness to have it happen, and then we can have it happen bottom up. But without very strong push, it does not happen. It's too difficult. So this is, okay, maybe a bit for our own company, but I really believe so. I mean, it doesn't have to be a why innovation or not, but the message I want to pass here is that an organization to transform needs a partner. You cannot transform only by yourself, right? You can't change without bringing new external knowledge and push and new blood into the transformation. You have to have a partner, okay? Consulting, whatever you want to call it, coaches, You got to have that. I just, through my career and through my experience, I want to say here that the kind of partner that you want to have is usually an agile partner. It's usually, how to put it? I don't want to be overly negative, but what I want to say is this agile transformation is not a classical transformation process. It's not about consultants coming and telling to a company what to do, what are the best practices, and deploying so-called best practices. An agile transformation is about an agile partner coming in like a catalyst, helping the companies to find out its new way of working. We are not bringing solution, we are enabling the transformation, right? So this is a radical shift compared to traditional consulting delivery model. This slide that we have you have here, I like it very much. I have used these slides for about 20 years. There is nothing new here. It is not about agile. It's about change management. It's about transformation. And it's about the fact that you need to have a program for a transformation like this. This kind of transformation cannot happen by itself. It has to be planned. It has to be staffed. It has to be measured. It has to be continuously reviewed and organized. So that's a very important thing for me. I don't believe transformation can be successful without very strong management. I mentioned a bit about upskill, right? So when it comes to competences, so in a digital transformation, you need to have new technology skills, AI, data, chatbot, this, mobile, okay. But there is also a lot of new skills that are required in terms of way of working and instead of in terms of behavior. Right, and this is what I want to stress here is our way to work on the skills is to usually define, process, capture this thing into a framework, have very good, whatever, scrum master, delivery master, leaders, servant leaders to enforce these practices and this knowledge and to have our teams having this kind of burger, you know, the framework on one hand, the reinforcement of a framework in the other hand, and people then adopting these practices. And when I talk about new skills, it's not only about training, all right? It's a lot about coaching and mentoring. So what we usually call agile coaching, I prefer to call it mentoring. It's really about show and tell. It's really about showing people how to do new practices, how to execute things in a different way when we are showing and telling and that we have the competence, right? So in Y Innovation, for example, most of our coaches, they are people who know how to do, they have done it themselves. And then they go to client and they explain to the teams and to the leaders and so on how to do things. For me, this is more the mentoring part, right? While the coaching is more about leadership, about behavior, not only leaders, but really about helping someone to find a new posture, to look at things from a different perspective. In that case, you cannot show and tell. I cannot tell you how you should be leading or how you should behave. All I can do is to have this kind of discussions with you in order for you to understand and look into it from a different perspective. And this is coaching. When it comes to monitoring, then I just put here an example, but I just want to show you, for example, in Y Innovation, when we talk about Scrum coaching, so say we are taking a couple of teams, bring them from traditional way of working to Scrum, this is the number of things we're going to do with the team. All right, so each box here represents usually one workshop or one session of work. So as you can see, it's pretty extensive. There is, and I'm just talking about Scrum here, right? We have the same for Kanban, we have the same for different framework, we have some similar things for agile leadership and servant leadership and so on. I also like to talk about the being agile versus doing agile. And I think you all know this this slide. My experience about transformation is that doing and being go together. So very often I hear some people who think being agile is the most important. Yes, yes, of course it is. Of course it is. I think we can all agree on this. But now, in order to be agile, right, in order to acquire the mindset of being agile, how do you get this mindset? How do you transform in being agile? The only way to transform in being agile is doing it. So it's a bit like a yoga, you know. If you are not born with the culture of yoga and you go for lessons of yoga, first you need to do, you need to practice. And the more you practice, the more you start to understand the benefit of yoga and you start to understand the philosophical aspect of it. And the more you get the philosophical aspect, the better you do it. And the better you do it, the more you get it. So it's a virtuous cycle, right? But it starts by doing. And this is what I learned over years. You can't teach people of being agile. They need to experiment it. Dimensioning. So this is also something that is important. And indeed, a lot of organizations, they fail with their agile transformation because they don't have the critical mass. They don't put enough effort in it. If you don't put enough effort, you don't have momentum. You don't move fast enough. You don't transform fast enough. It must be a pace in a transformation. So 3% is what we usually consider the number, the workload of a transformation. So let me just explain this figure. If I want to transform a company with 100 people in it, all right, an organization with 100 people, I usually consider that 3 people full-time will be necessary to do this transformation. I believe that below this amount of effort, we will not succeed, right? So that's usually my threshold. In terms of the way we're going to work with transformation, a transformation to Agile is an organizational innovation. So the transformation itself is innovation. What you are trying to do is to invent a new way of working for a company, right? So it's an invention. Well, it's an invention. It's an innovation. It's about building this new way of working. And for this, we need to use really the innovation processes, thinking, and so on. So as I said before, it's not about coming with best practice. It's about finding out, testing things, trying to achieve, solve problems, testing new solutions that come from Agile, see if it works, and really having this build, test, learn culture. So you need to transform the same way you will build an innovative product, right? So same, the transformation is itself an Agile process. And of course, one thing that, you know, that's what you were saying before, guys, the leaders, they want it to happen overnight. They want it to be very fast. They are always rush, rush, rush. But actually, it takes time. It's a maturity thing. It's there is a need for the teams, for people, for the organization as well to transform, and it takes a lot of time. I would like to remind you guys, make you know, companies that have transformed to Agile. If I talk about a company like ING, right, which is probably one of the banks that has been the most advanced, it's been 10 years. Right, I started with ING back in Netherlands in 2010, and they are still transforming now. So I've been working with companies like BNP Paribas for 6 years. They are still moving on. DBS has been starting their agile journey 6 years ago, and they are still on. So it's a very long process, and it takes time, and the management also need to understand that they need to be patient. So before I move to the SIA case, this is what we do in Y Innovation and the way we structure our transformation programs. So we have usually these key components in the transformation. The first thing is usually have a clear transformation roadmap. As I said before, it's a program. You need to have a vision of where we are going. We need to have quantitative objectives of why we are doing it. Okay, so usually we have a transformation roadmap, business goals for the transformation that are clearly defined. It's not a sequential thing here, right? It's an iterative process altogether, but we need to capture ways of working, a framework, right, that captures this, the new way of working. And you need to then train and coach people to adopt things, right? You need to really build it bottom up. You need to change usually the organization design of companies, the traditional organization based on functional silos. is usually a key impediment to agile transformation and real agile adoption, right? So if an organization don't see their own organization structure is blocking agility, we have a problem. We need to work on this first. And of course, then once we start moving into the agile way of working, one thing that is required is to build lateral communities in order to really enable knowledge transfer, and so on. At the center of the transformation process, you need two components. One is data, right? Measurement to prove that we are making, we are delivering value through the agile transformation, that agile adoption by the company is delivering value. And the second thing that we need is a very strong communication and promotion of the work we are doing and of the values of agile. Call it propaganda if you want, I'm fine, but it's required. Change management and change transformation requires a change of mindset. And change of mindset can only be done through promotion, communication, and working on the minds.